This SciShow video is supported by Jump, a statistical discovery software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. You can head to jmp.com/scishow for a free 30-day trial. One of the things I think is really cool about studying paleontology is how much it's like a detective story. Figuring out the past is often all about clues, logical deductions, and timelines. And like any good detective story, sometimes there's a twist, a new piece of evidence that flips the entire thing and forces us to ask, what's really going on here? And case in paleontological point, about 575 million years ago, there was a massive boom in animal life, and for decades, we've thought that the trigger was a whole bunch of extra oxygen that appeared right beforehand. But in today's episode, we'll explain why that timeline might be backwards and how paleontological detectives piece that together. So it's 575 million years ago, and the Earth has just thawed from a massive ice age. Down in the deep bottom of the oceans, large, complex, multicellular life is first appearing in a big way. Life had existed on Earth before this, but for the most part, it had been small, unicellular things. Think like bacteria and algae, with the occasional bigger splotch of a critter. But suddenly, the fossil record just blooms, with things like feathery-looking rangeomorphs, odd little disc-shaped fellows, and what may be early sponges or coral-like cnidarians like Heutia. And some of these guys could be big, almost 2 meters long. This proliferation is called the Avalon Explosion. And while there would undoubtedly be even larger and more spectacular life forms to come, you can think of this time period as kind of like the Earth's proof of concept for ecosystems full of big, complex life. But as for what caused this bloom, that's where a bit of detective work comes in. And one of the major clues for the cause of all of this is called the Shuram Excursion, which is kind of sounds like the title of a mystery book. But rather than a bestseller, the Shuram Excursion was actually a massive worldwide swing in carbon isotopes recorded in rocks dating to right around the same time as this Avalon Explosion. And one of the hypotheses to explain the Shuram Excursion is changes in the Earth's carbon cycle, which could have been brought on by the sudden appearance of a lot of extra oxygen in the deep ocean. The idea is that all that extra oxygen would have chemically reacted with and released organic carbon stored in the deep ocean, think dead algae and stuff, which would have then been spread around the world and showed up in rocks, like those in the Shuram Excursion. But scientists don't know exactly what would have caused this hypothetical increase in oxygen. If the Shuram Excursion was due to extra oxygen in the deep ocean, it would seem to support the theory that the mysterious explosion of life during that period was connected. And animals need oxygen to live, so if there's more oxygen in the deep ocean, you could have more animals down there too. But here's the twist. A 2023 paper suggests that the isotopes, and by extension the biodiversity bloom, happened without any oxygen increase, which goes against what researchers have thought for decades. And they came to this conclusion by going back to the scene of the crime, so to speak. They looked at the rocks in Oman, called the Shuram Formation, that were the original evidence for the Shuram Excursion. They examined not just carbon, but also two other elements, iron and thallium. Taking samples of the rocks, they used X-ray fluorescence and mass spectrometry, which are, in short, ways to determine what's in a sample by bombarding it with X-rays and seeing how it glows, or by comparing a particle's masses and charges respectively. And they concluded that, based on the specific types of iron and thallium they found in the samples, that those rocks could have only formed in oxygen-poor water, not the oxygen-rich water that people had assumed was around during that time. But wait. If it was oxygen poor, then that means the excursion happened before any big oxygen increase. And if the animals happened at the same time as the excursion, then that means they also came before. It upsets the whole timeline. So that means, if this is right, that multicellular life was able to develop just fine with way less oxygen than we thought would have been required. It means that the conditions which first gave the world multicellular organisms were way harsher and more demanding of those early living things than we ever gave them credit for, and that these creatures came about not because of the conditions of the world they lived in, but in spite of them. Now, to be clear, this is just one line of new evidence suggesting that oxygen isn't the culprit. Other papers argue that there's still plenty of room for our friend O2 in this story. Which means the real answer to this investigative puzzle is we don't know. It's still a mystery to be solved. Maybe this is a red herring, or maybe this is the clue that'll end up shining a new light on the whole case. But it does raise a lot of questions about other assumptions. Why would multicellular life thrive in such harsh conditions? If oxygen wasn't important, then what was? We don't really have the answers yet. But rest assured, paleo detectives are on the case. Thank you to Jump for supporting this SciShow video. At SciShow, we believe that education is a human right, and Jump is right there with us as a software based on the idea that statistics should be accessible to everyone. Jump was designed with scientists and engineers in mind, but it's ideal for anyone solving problems with data. The software is jam-packed with tools for data preparation, analysis, graphing, and so much more, making it easy to go from raw data to meaningful analysis in just a few clicks with no coding required. Plus, Jump integrates R, Python, and SQL support for smooth analytic workflows. It basically doesn't matter what kind of file your data is coming from or what coding language you're working with. Jump works with the systems you already have in place. And Jump offers a 30-day free trial for anyone, anywhere. So to see the benefits of visual statistics for yourself, you can go to jmp.com/scishow, and thank you for watching.